Hedging is a risk management strategy used by oil and gas companies and investors to protect themselves against unfavorable oil price movements in the market. Essentially, hedging involves taking an opposite position in a related security or financial instrument to offset potential losses in another. When it comes to oil and gas, hedging is particularly important because the energy market is known for its price volatility. Factors such as geopolitical tension, natural disasters, and changes in supply and demand can cause significant fluctuations in oil and gas prices and make it challenging for the companies to stay profitable. Oil and gas hedging helps companies stabilize their cash flow and protect themselves from potential losses due to price fluctuations. The most common hedging instruments used in oil and gas industry are future contracts, option contracts, swaps, and collars. If you're an investor, understanding how companies in the energy sector manage their risk can help you make better informed decisions. Companies with effective hedging strategies may be better positioned to handle market volatility and maintain stable cash flow, making them potentially more attractive investments. So let's break down each of these hedging methods and take a look at some specific examples. A future contract represents a commitment between the two companies or individuals to purchase or trade a specific volume of oil and gas at a pre-established rate on a specified date in the future. By locking in the price, the company is protecting itself against potential losses if the market price were to drop below the current level. However, if the market price goes up, the company would not benefit from the higher price. Here's an example of how futures might be used by oil and gas companies. An oil producer is concerned about falling oil prices over the next 6 months. To hedge against this risk, the producer enters into a futures contract to sell specific quantities of oil at a predetermined price in 6 months. If the market price falls below the agreed upon price, the producer is protected from the negative impact on its revenue. Options give the company the choice without being required to purchase or sell a particular amount of oil and gas at set price on or prior to a certain date. This provides more flexibility than the futures contract because it allows the company to benefit from favorable price movements while still limiting potential losses. The two main kinds of options are put options and call options. A call option gives the holder the right to buy, while a put option gives the holder the right to sell. So here's an example. A natural gas distributor wants to hedge against rising natural gas prices during the winter months. The distributor purchases a call option, giving it the right to buy natural gas at a predetermined price during the winter. And if the market price rises above the agreed upon price, the distributor can exercise the option and buy natural gas at a lower price, protecting its profit margins. A swap is a financial agreement between two parties to exchange cash flows based on the price of oil and gas. In an oil and gas swap, one party agrees to pay a fixed price while the other party pays a floating price, typically based on the market index. The difference between the fixed and floating prices is settled periodically, allowing the company to reduce its exposure to price fluctuations. A collar is a combination of put option and call option. The company buys a put option to protect itself from falling prices and sells a call option to offset the cost of the put. This creates a price range or collar in which the company is protected from price fluctuations. Financial institutions such as banks and hedge funds often act as intermediaries, facilitating the transactions between companies and helping them manage their risk. Additionally, financial institutions may also take an opposite side of the hedge, assuming the risk themselves to profit from potential market movements.